team. Congratulate the whole team. But when you riding like we riding with each other, yeah. Ain't no I in this.
See, we came up from the bottom, me and squad got it. Now we made it through them problems, now it's God body. We eat, sleep, breathe, it's way.
First opened in 2002. There's a look inside Ford Field here in downtown Detroit, the Motor City. Today, we've got a Week 13 matchup for you here between the Jacksonville Jaguars and the Detroit Lions. December, and we're in the home stretch now as we're underway in Week 13. From the end zone, here comes Williams. Swift to start the drive. They find some open field here. Their first play from scrimmage is a pickup of 13. Well, there you go. This offense off to a strong start this afternoon.
Yeah, with a big run and a first down. That's putting what you practice into play. That's excellent execution to get things started.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. To throw, Goff goes with the out route and completes it to Swift, calling a gain of 3 on the play, and it's second down. The Lions had a woeful 2-9 on the year, and they've lost 3 straight here, and it kind of goes without saying, I guess, but they could certainly use a win.
Yeah, no doubt about that. There's a difference between a losing stretch and a losing streak, and right now they're not playing their best football, but if they were to fall here, and now you're looking at going 4 games without a win, things can start compounding themselves pretty quickly from this point forward.
And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
And a missed tackle there as he pushes forward for a gain of 4.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Right back to Swift again on second down. Call it a gain of 1 yard, and it's going to bring up 3rd and 5. Not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks. There's Gone. The open man is Shark. It's complete. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 15-yard line.
That's another Lions.
Well, they're running here on the jet sweep. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. He'll lose 1 yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
Part of their struggles last week was getting these negative plays on 1st and 2nd down. That's something they have to be wary of as this game continues.
Now it's Goff off the bootleg. And he's going to go down. He's sacked back at the 24. They push him back 8 yards that time on 2nd down.
This offensive line has struggled. In fact, when we sat down with the coach, he said it's been in tatters lately. They allowed 6 sacks in their last game. Just gave up another one right there.
In tatters, so it sounds a little bit like this right now.
He rifles one that's intercepted. And now off to the races, down the right side. touchdown.
So just a tremendous play there defensively on this opening drive, not just to make the interception, but to take it all the way home.
And it felt like this was a defense that was on its heels a bit to start this thing off.
Yeah, they pretty much let the other guys march right down the field until that moment.
Yeah, key play there. Turned it all around. Big moment.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away.
From the end zone, here comes Williams. And not a good return here at all as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line.
For most people, the excitement of a kickoff return is to see a long one that goes back in the opposite direction. But for the guys covering it, it's being able to stop them deep in their own territory. How about that incredible form tackle right there? Shoulder in the ball carrier, and down he goes.
DeJuan Smoot there to bring him down.
And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, and that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends are like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Meanwhile, Goff's throw taken in by Hockenson here.
And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. First time these two have hooked up this afternoon, and it's a first down. From the gun, here's Goff.
Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. It's Devin Lloyd with a pick.
And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
An excellent play there, CD, on the pick six. And I think were they in nickel? Did they have an extra DB out there?
Yeah, Brandon, I think they were in standard nickel, not the Buffalo, as teams like to call it, meaning three safeties for big nickel. They just wanted to take away the quarterback's throwing lanes, and that's exactly what they did and came through with a big-time pick six.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
Here comes Khalif Raymond from his end zone.
And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath. First, do no harm. And right now, they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis. So they'll come up after the gain of seven on a second and three. They'll stay on the ground with Swift. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. That one, a first down pickup of eight. Now, look, that wasn't a huge gain, but those are the types of carries I think they were missing in their loss last week. They couldn't get him going on the ground.
Did you get the same feeling I did during our meetings, that they kind of regretted that he didn't touch the
Absolutely.
Ball?
Absolutely.
You know, hey, he should have touched it more last week. They weren't going to make that same mistake, and they've taken care of that early.
14-0 to score. This is the NFL.
Behind the chain, second and 13.
They'll try the air now with Goff. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time, wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately, had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. A real letdown defensively. That was third and a bundle. But they allow the conversion.
Back to the running game with Swift.
And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
We think, Brandon, I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in these first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job, but they're doing more than that, aren't they? They're getting a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example right there for the loss on the tackle.
They'll find Williams on the slant. And he'll be brought down just shy of 40.
These guys have definitely been out played in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball, and what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drive.
And yet again, Goff is intercepted. Picked off by Andre Sisco. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Wow, this one, it is getting out of hand early. They add a pick six to the ledger now. Three-score lead still in the first half.
And all that celebrating that you see and hear from those defenders is not just because they scored a touchdown on a pick six. It's because they're pitching a shutout in this one. Every defender's dream.
And they'll accept that penalty. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. From the end zone, here comes Williams. And nowhere to go. He only makes it to the five.
Well, not exactly a banner return, so he doesn't give his offense a whole lot of room to work with. They've got to go a long way now to try and score some points. I do know this from experience. There will be a few comments muttered his way by the offense as they head out on the field.
A beautiful fake. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 10-yard line. That'll give him eight that time, and it'll be second in a couple.
8 yards on the pickup. Brings up second and two.
Cooper, 66!
Gone. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked by Chad Muma. And they're going to get the football just outside the 10 at the 11-yard line. And they'll take possession already in the red zone and in a great spot to add points to the scoreboard.
And Brandon, how many times have we seen a defense with a lot of field behind them get even more aggressive, right? They feel like they've got them not pinned down, but in a favorable spot for them. And they took advantage of it there. Got a nice interception and set up their offense in great shape.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
The strong windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down. Patterson's kick is good, and the route is on. It's 24 to nothing. So the interception set him up with terrific field position, but 3 points, the end result.
Yeah, we can make this one pretty simple, partner. You always want to end drives with points, but that's one that you're going to look back on and probably say, we should have done better there.
And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. So first and 10 now from the 30. Goff a handoff here to Swift. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defense in front. Because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
And he'll be marked down at about the 26-yard line. A big play there for Detroit. 41 yards. We remind you that coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will be alongside. He'll have highlights and analysis from Orlando of this first half of action. To throw is gone. They'll try and set up the screen to Swift. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. Not what they had in mind there. That's going to go as a loss of 4.
Well, Brandon, we could see that play developing, and they were hoping that he was going to be able to put a move on the first guy and turn it into a big play. but no such luck. The speed on defense continues to get better and better in the NFL. Pretty nice example there of those guys being able to run from their assignments and finish off that play.
A gain of 8 there on the play. And now 3rd down and 6 to go.
They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains.
Throwing on 3rd. Goff. It's caught on the right side. Williams. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
And this is an offense in need of getting a few good things to happen. Here's one right here. They've had their share of struggles in key moments, but that's a nice throw. A nice work after the throw, and they're set up now with a 1st and goal.
And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. Second down and goal. Goff. And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. Amon-Ra St. Brown. As the first half is winding down. And the Lions are on the board here in the final seconds of the 1st half. Extra point by Seibert. Up and good. And that'll make it 24-7.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this 1st half as the kicks away. From his end zone, here comes Agnew. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive.
And with a 3-score lead already, this is not time for a momentum change, so I'd imagine they'd be happy to just take this into the locker room.
So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number 3 here. And how about this line out of the locker room? An onside kick attempt. The Jaguars in possession of the lead, and they will get the football as we are underway in the 2nd half. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the 2nd half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators, they sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? Now I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach, we can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run.
Looking to throw, Lawrence. That's out wide here for Robinson. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line.
Caught that look from me there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his 1st catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the 2nd half.
Could be 4-down territory even if they don't get this, but they need just a few inches here on 3rd. Now Lawrence to throw. That's caught. It's Dan Arnold, the tight end. And he will have a Jaguars 1st down as that'll be a pickup of about 5 as they convert on 3rd and inches. On 1st and 10, it's Lawrence. Open man right side is Ingram. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And out of bounds all the way down at the 3. They give him a gain of 37.
And CD, we have seen some great runs the last few times we've been together, but I think we could at least put this one in our top 5. That was a determined gallop there.
Yeah, and this defense has had its share of problems getting guys to the ground. And here's another example. They never should have allowed this play to gain as many yards as it did, but poor tackling early in the play led to big yardage after the fact.
And you can see the distance traveled there after the initial contact on the next-gen stats.
And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. Yikes, a 4-yard loss really sets him back now for second down.
And now defensively, you have to look at this like the game's on the line. It's just the third quarter, but another touchdown given up here could really spell an end to their chances, so they need to toughen up and keep them out of the end zone.
A good display of power, but ultimately it gets him just inside the 5 to the 4 and no further. Only 3 yards there on the completion. That'll lead to a 3rd and goal.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran it a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
On 3rd and goal, Lawrence.
And he fires one that's intercepted. It's the linebacker, Alex Anzalone. And the Lions are going to take possession here at their own 3-yard line.
Well, still down quite a bit here, several scores. But, yeah, at least that's a start, Charles, getting the interception here. And look, we're still in the 3rd quarter, so this thing not done yet.
You're right about that, Brandon. This defense, they haven't quit on this game. They stayed with it and got an interception and handed the ball back to their offense. And what you wonder about is the team that just threw that interception, they've got to be careful about developing a sense of complacency and thinking this game is over.
So forget about being backed up. Here's a 1st and 10 all the way across midfield. A shotgun snap for Goff.
He'll go right back to St. Brown.
And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard.
Made the quick throw there outside the numbers, and you can feel the thought process. They just wanted to get in his hands and let him make a play. But how about the job they did defensively to keep him bottled up? Instead, they tackle him for a loss.
Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Goff. And that'll be caught. It's St. Brown. And he's going to have another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 28. It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh set of downs.
On 1st and 10, it's Swift.
Credited with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Flushed out right.
That pass caught. It's Williams.
And in for the Lions touchdown.
Jameson Williams.
His 4th touchdown on the year.
And the Lions get a bit closer.
Extra point by Seibert. Up and good. And the lead down to 10, 24-14. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away.
From his end zone, here comes Agnew.
Oh, a good return up past the 30. Jamal Agnew. And he will score. Touchdown.
That was a special return, and it happened because he's a special returner. He has to have that approval from his special teams coach's head coach to bring it out of the end zone.
But let's be honest, a lot of times when they bring it out of the end zone like he did there, they don't have approval. I mean, I think a lot of times they do, but correct me if I'm wrong. Sometimes it's just a guy getting a feel, right?
Exactly right. What's the old adage? Sometimes you just have to know when to break the rules. And if you do, you're taking on some responsibility. But he was happy to do so there.
From the end zone, here comes Williams. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback,
It has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
Goff's throw going into the hands of Williams.
They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first.
Goff on third down. And my goodness, another interception. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Well, if there was any thought that this thing might turn around for this offense in the second half, I think those thoughts pretty well dashed after that interception return there.
It just has not been a good outing for this unit whatsoever. There's no other way to say it. They've been overmatched, haven't performed to the level that they've needed, and that throw there just going to contribute to this game getting out of hand.
From the end zone, here comes Williams.
The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. It's a game that they would rather probably forget about, at least to this point, Charles. And one reason is turnovers. The turnover on the last drive, they had the issue in the first half as well. And that's really, unfortunately for them, helped to put this game out of reach.
And you know they won't admit it to themselves, but we know that winning the game is pretty much out of the picture now. So their bottom line is, how do they play a clean game the rest of this one, right? Take care of the football, no more turnovers, and see how that works.
Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And that'll cut this to a 17-point spread. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
From his end zone, here comes Agnew.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw.
Aleem McNeil, what an effort to get in there and drop it.
So both offenses come to life here in this third quarter as this is shaping up for a good finish.
You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15. Another try after the first down sack. Lawrence. And that's complete ETN out of the backfield. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. So give him 2 yards there on the completion. And that'll make it third and 13. Lawrence going up top, and he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
Whether that's a little grabbing, a little hand fighting, by any means necessary on third down, he's able to get the job done in the secondary and swat that one away.
It'll be a net of 40 yards there following a 43-yard punt, 3-yard return, and the Lions will take over.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And you see a lot of frustrated faces as they are inching closer to a fourth straight loss.
Now a first down throw, gone. And that's hauled in by St. Brown over the middle.
And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line. A three-score game here late. You can probably rule out the comeback, but certainly some kind of a moral victory to be had if they can get a few more points to close things out. And to that end, a nice pass play there to push things downfield.
Yeah, and we know in this league,
a loss is a loss, and no one wants anything to count as a moral victory or, boy, something that feels a little bit cheap. But they trim that lead down to just two scores. That's still a benefit to this squad.
This linebacking core, they've done a good job of keeping that running game in check, haven't they?
They certainly have, and what they'll also do when this game is over is thank the guys up front, the big defensive line, because they've kept them clean, so to speak, not letting blockers get to them, allowing them to run to the football and keep that running game bottled up.
And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 29-yard line. A good pick up there of 20 yards. First and two. From the gun, here's Swift. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely, pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there. And he is going to have a Lions first down by about a yard. It's a gain of 5 on third and four. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. From the red zone now, gone. Over the middle, hauled in by Shark. And they're going to get this down inside the 15. Second down and 7. They run out of the gun with Swift. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
The Lions on third down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This is 3rd and 7. Goff now looks to throw. He'll be hit and taken down at the 21. Trayvon Walker in there to record the 2nd sack of his young NFL career.
Well, you could almost see his eyes light up defensively. I mean, as a linebacker, that's about as quick as you can get to a quarterback.
So what did your 3rd grade teacher teach you about straight lines, right? As soon as you have those, you take full advantage of them. He found a gap in the offensive line, got to the quarterback, and put him on the deck.
Desperation time for Goff on 4th. And now here is another interception. And the Jags are going to get this back to their own 34-yard line.
Yet another interception, and I just had to double-check my math. But it is now 8 between last week and this week.
Well, I just used a calculator. I didn't worry about double-checking it. But the thing that always throws me when you see quarterbacks in this type of a bad spot, they're trying to figure out what they can do to change it, and sometimes they try too hard, and they never get out of it. And that's where he is right now. He's just locked in a really bad way.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. Here's Robinson again on 2nd down. And he stopped immediately there. Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8.
All runners count on their eyes to find the gaps increases, to find open space. There was absolutely none on that one. Totally swallowed up on that play.
And Ingram hauls it in. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48. A much better effort we're seeing from him under center this week versus last week when he threw 4 picks.
He has thrown the 1 in this game, but you're right. When you cut it down from 4 the previous week, and we always talk about adjustments, well, he made some in practice, and he continues to work on it during the game. I'm sure he's getting plenty of reminders about how to stay in the moment, stay focused on the task.
And he's got him in the driver's seat here in the 4th quarter. This will be a win for Jacksonville. And I tell you what, I can't remember a defensive performance as good as this one. They seemingly forced turnover after turnover after turnover every time you turned around.
Yeah, you can just keep going with it, can't you? After turnover, after turnover. as this game unfolded, they were doing all the dictating, right? They dealt the offense exactly how it was going.
Hello, new world, all the boys and girls. I got some true stories to tell. You're back outside, but they still lied. Whoa, yeah.
Take off the foo-foo. Take off the cloud chase. Take off the Wi-Fi. Take off the money phone. Take off the car loan. Take off the flex and the white loss. Take off the word jury. I'ma take 10 steps, then I'm taking off top off. Take off some fabricated streams and the microwave memes. It's a real world outside. Take off your idols. Take off the runway. Take off the Cairo. Take off the Sandro. Pay 5 days stay. Take off for the meal. Hella value. Take off the far flag. Take off perception. Take off the cop with the iPad. Take off the allure, take off the unsure, take off decisions I lack. Take off the fake deep, take off the fake woke, take off the I'm broke, I care. Take off the gossip, take off the new logic, that if I'm rich, I'm real. Take off the shit mill, take off the doge, take off the breaking bag. Take all that designer off and what do you have?
You ugly,
you out of pocket.
Two ATMs, you stepping to what?
You out of pocket.
Who you think they talk about? Talk about us.
You out of pocket.
Who you think they carry up?
The world in a panic, the women is stranded, the men on the run. The profits abandoned, the law take advantage, the market is crashing, the industry wants to sleep in the box while they making a mockery following us. This ain't monopoly, watch it for love. This ain't monogamy, y'all get it. Jumping on what the hell is that? I gotta relax when I feel. All my descendants, they come in my secret, say I am too real. I'm done with the sensitive, taking it personal. Done with the black and the white, the wrong and the right. You hoping for change and miracles. I know the feelings that came with burial's cries.
You ugly,
you out of pocket.
Two ATMs, you stepping to what?
You out of pocket.
Who you think they talk about? Talk about us.
You out of pocket.
Who you think they carry up us?
Serving up a look, dancing in a drop. Hello to the big step, but never lose a count. Venting in the safe house. Venting in the safe.
Can I fit out my truth? I got nothing to lose. I got problems and fools. I can swim in my fate. Cameras moving whenever I'm moving. The family suing whatever I make. Murder is stacking. The president acting. The government taxing my funds in the bank. Homies ejecting the fence when I'm breaking. Look at my reaction. My pupils on skates. Hold up, hold up.
Let's think about this for a second. Tell me what you would do for steady. We show your show no credit. We show your bro for leverage.
What a hypocrite say. What community feel they the only ones relevant? What a hypocrite say. What community feel they the only ones relevant?
You out of pocket, yeah, you out of pocket. You entertain the mediocre, need to stop it. You entertaining old friends when they toxic. What's your life like? The gossip.
What the fuck is council culture, dog? Say what I want about you, but I'm like overdog. I treat you like I'm Jigga, watch I own it all. Oh, you worry about a critic, that ain't protocol.
A wild hood, only new goons since my childhood. Say anything in their raps, I was in the house with it. We don't respect fake jewelry and silly outfits. Window down, blowing out great tits. New York's J Prince on Houston Street. I caught the bounce before my even bounced the beat. I took the hard way in it, man, it's the route for me. Run me the keys, run me the bees, run me that flow back. The top three, I'm not number one, how could you post that? I win the crown, the city is mine, you cannot hold that. I'm not the one to go back, meet Joe Black. Run me the keys, run me the bees, run me that flow back. The top three, I'm not number one, how could you post that? I win the crown, the city is mine, you cannot hold that. I'm not the one to go back, meet Joe Black, meet Joe Black.
Toss me blessings, you never throw interceptions. I catch them like Odie Beckham. Hard to not the devil when built like Tiana Teller. And balling at 27, I feel like Iman Shepherd. Know there's a disconnect when the sheep start to lead the shepherd. The weak start to be aggressive, the streets start to be the reverend. Bragging about first class, seated on 9/11. They spirits are not united, a legion, my soul forever. I murder my adolescents, assault with a friendly weapon. I verbally dissect them to help them get back together. Wanting the stranger things, I handle it like 11. My point is I guard the kids. I should play for the Celtics. Watch how I Euro step them and curry them like I'm stepping whenever I'm in your town. No endeavors. I manifest my endeavors. I'm blessed and I'm getting better. I walk amongst living legends. Coach Contra will live forever.
New goals, new goals, baby boo. Got my wrist in these grits, tryna whip some new. I am sick of this rabbit, rabbit, rabbit. So are you. Hold on, switch. Mama, I'm gonna introduce my ego. Since the world full of villains, then let's introduce the heroes. We the good guys, no blood on our hands. And it's Tito, she a pack. Finna guarantee those move back. Type of view is that on the globe. It's a visionary peeking out the window of my soul. Might just fall back, lend a helping hand and play my role. You ain't all that, all in the mirror oversold. Call me Reason I, a.k.a. Malcolm X, L. That's a big pun, bigger punishment. I give him hell, get done. Keep it blunt enough, you can't. Cough drop, tell them hard for their health.
Al final he encontrado el negrito con los colorados. El mejor desde Colombia a los estados. Para los que no piensan que yo soy mejor, tú estás. Tengo todos tus raperos favoritos paniqueados, ten cuidado. Estos raperos son mis hijos jautados. Acuérdate que ni hizo el sonido que te ha gustado. Pídeme permiso when you copy my style. This bridge, I done broke them all with a freestyle. Black on both sides de Colombia, all your peep style. Como yo lo hago, ain't nobody funny do it now. Up the uptown, all the way down through the south. No hay nadie que pueda conmigo, Dios es mi testigo. I'm the one that shut it down. Just the light from a vision that I had in the dark. Tunnel vision on the bigger picture. The trust, wanna play the game, but don't never play their part.
Since the beginning, I play offensive D, I might switch my position. La mama was thirsty, so I had to quench. I'ma drive real fast, cause you know I shoot quick. Just like Travis Kelsey, I be having emotions. Just like the lamb, I ain't know I'm exploding. My heart cold, bad, I ain't got emotions. I'm going hard, yeah, you know I'm devoted. We running streets, yeah, you know we control.
controller. She love the kids, she be busting it over. I'm quarterbacking like I'm Kyler Murray. Trying to win, I'm up at practice early. Going crazy, I just rubbed a jersey. It's the first half and we done dropped 30.
We just underscoring them, boy, man. I told my boss, it ain't no limit.